miten ei merkattu edes Skypeita. Tervetuloa tänne Vantsaan, joka sijaitsee täällä Tansanian koillispäässä, aivan Lake Victoria-järven rannalla. Vantsa on liikenteellisesti ja kaupallisesti tärkeä keskus. Asukkaita täällä on 400 000. Ja tämä rautatie vie Dar es Salaami. Kyyti kestää kuulemma parisen päivää. Täällä on myös vilkas lauttaliikenne. Täällä pääsee lautalla vaikkapa Keniaan tai Ugandaan. Kansallinen lentokenttä sijaitsee tuolla. Sieltä on hyvät yhteydet Kilimanjaron kansainväliselle kentälle. Ja maanteitse täältä pääsee vaikkapa Keniaan. Rooma rakennettiin aikoinaan 7 kukkulalle Tarun mukaan, mutta Vantsa panee paremmaksi. Koko kaupunki on oikeastaan täynnä oudonmuodoisia, hauskan näköisiä kukkuloita, josta kuuluisin on tämä Bismarck, joka toimii myöskin sataman maamerkkinä. Nimi Bismarck muistuttaa meitä siitä aikakaudesta, jolloin Tansania kuului Saksan siirtomaakuntiin. Tämä suhde loppui ensimmäiseen maailmansotaan. Kannattaa maksaa 1500 paikallista shilliä. Well, Melanie, how come you ended up here on the shores of Lake Victoria?
Now, someone told me about 2 Dutch guys living down here, trying to build a hotel.
Get and Jan,
those are the ones. Well, I thought, well, maybe that's my entrance in, you know, Dutch company down here, maybe we can work something out. So I wrote them a fax and I told them who I was and what I wanted. And I offered to come by and see if I could help them out a bit. They said, please do so and hurry up. I was here in 3 weeks. I got here on a Sunday evening, Monday morning. They said, okay, you're the manager. There's the office. This is the lake. That town down there, that is where you do the shopping. Go ahead.
So you got stung by the African disease.
Yeah,
how would you describe the African disease? What is it?
I guess it's the freedom, the liberty, the climate. Different from Europe. Europe is so crowded, too full, too busy, too stressed out. You know, when you get here and you feel the quietness and the sound, and it gets to you.
Täällä Victoria-järven rannalla löytyy lukemattomia kalastajakyliä. Yksi niistä on nimeltään Lamadi, jossa me juuri ollaan käymässä. Mark siinä neuvottelee kylän vanhimman kanssa, joka on samalla tietenkin kylän päällikkö. Täällä on jonkinnäköinen keskustori ja väen paljous aika hurja. Valkoinen mies on ilmeisesti yhä aikamoinen harvinaisuus tässä kylässä. Ja pian ollaan sitten lähdössä kalaan tonne Victorian kiskomaan nuottaa. Katsotaan, onko onni suosiollinen tänne. Kuulemma tuuli tulee väärästä suunnasta, mutta let's see. How long could this be? So, what are you doing down there?
Stuck
you're stuck in the swamp. And now we see it coming. Oh! Hey, Mark! Come back, man!
Bring your hand.
Yes, I'm a traveling man. Serengeti on masai-kieltä ja tarkoittaa loputonta tasankoa, ja näin se myös ensisilmäykseltä näyttää. Puisto ponkaisi maailman maineeseen vuonna 1959 saksalaiseläintieteilijä Bernhard Grzimekin kirjalla Serengeti ei saa kuolla. Ja täällä kuvattiin myös John Waynen kuuluisa Afrikka-elokuva Hatari.
Now here's a nice bend of the Grumeti River, and what we see here is two different groups of hippos. One down there and the other down there. How many would you guess there's down there?
I think there's probably about 10 down here, and then much more along the bend down here. This river runs all through Serengeti.
Yeah.
From the eastern side and northern side, all the way out through the western quarter where we are now. And during the migration period, when it's here, it's very active. The Western Corridor, which is usually June, July. And you also find crocodiles here.
How do they get along with the crocodiles then?
They don't interfere with each other. The hippo's too big for the crocs to bother, really. Only rarely will you have a young hippo getting attacked, but it's uncommon, so they live in a somewhat kind of harmony here.
What do they actually eat?
During the evening, they leave the water and they go outside on these trails here.
Yes.
Very well-trodden tracks up into the plains here to graze.
Graze?
Graze and browse. And you'll see them in the evening, they'll come out and you make sure you're never in their way because it's one of the most dangerous animals here to encounter unless you're prepared.
And are they then spending the whole day?
During the day, they stay in the water where it's somewhat cool. And with their type of body and skin, they need to stay in the water and get that moisture.
So is there one dominant male then in a group like that?
You will have a dominant, and that's one of the reasons why they will be fighting with each other. And the most common cause of death for the hippo are the males fighting together.
Well, Gabriel, there's a whole lot of crocodiles in the river.
What I would say about these guys is that these are the Nile crocodiles. This area here, it's one of the river which has got a high concentration of crocodiles.
Yes.
And mostly, you know, it's because of the migration of the wildebeest which crosses here. So far right now, there's nothing crossing around. So the crocodiles are feeding mostly on fish and some few antelopes or whatever which comes to drink. That's why right now you see they're all swimming upwards, opening up their mouth. Anything entering in the mouth, they just swallow it.
How old can a crocodile get then?
They can live, you know, they live very long. It's different because they don't, you know, they relax a lot. Mm-hmm. And they don't lose their energy.
No.
Because they don't feed all the time. So they can go as up to 150 years.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Antilopien perhe on Serengetissä runsaslukuinen ja lajikkeita löytyy helpolla 10. Aluksi ne kaikki näyttävät samoilta, mutta parissa päivässä silmä harjaantuu ja erot selkiintyvät. Impala on vilkas, keskikokoinen antilooppi, jolla sarvet vain uroksilla. Impala liikkuu mielellään isoissa laumoissa. Dick Dick on pieni ja säikky ja siitä erikoinen, että elävät parittain. Suhde on elinikäinen, eikä puolisonsa menettänyt pariudu enää koskaan. Topi antiloppi on iso ja vanttera, molemmilla sukupuolilla sarvet ja siten vaikeita erottaa toisistaan. Topi pystyy elämään jopa kuukauden ilman vettä. Myös Grantin gaselilla on sarvet molemmilla sukupuolilla. Naarailla kuitenkin lyhyemmät. Välillä näkee isoja poikamieslaumoja, joissa jopa 40 jäsentä. Toisaalta yksittäisellä uroksella voi olla jopa parikymmentä naarasta haaremissaan. Tasan eivät käy onnenlahjat edes antiloopeilla.
So, there we have a nice group of giraffes again, I must say. There's a lot of them around.
Yes, in this park there's plenty as well as in the other park.
They seem to be quite sociable. They get along well together, at least it looks like that.
They're gregarious, and they're not in real tight herds, as this might imply, because there's a group here quite close together. Mm-hmm. They're usually in looser herds, spread out a little bit.
There's eight of them here. Is that a normal size for a group, or would you have even bigger ones on the move?
You could have larger groups. This is about average, and sometimes it's hard to tell because they spread out quite a lot when they're feeding.
Mm-hmm. And what do they eat? They eat directly from trees.
they're browsers.
Yeah.
So they're feeding off a lot of times off the acacias that we're
having
here.
Yeah, it's the leaves. Yeah. But the acacias, they are very sticky, so.
Yeah, well, because of the thorns, their tongues are very hard and have a lot of protection. So they can strip the leaves without getting...
You could say they have special equipment.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, how high would a big giraffe be?
Maximum about 5.5 meters.
Yeah, that's really tall.
Yes, the tallest animal. And for weight, the maximum about 1,200 kilos.
Now, how old would a big male become?
Well, maximum age about 25 years.
Yeah. Those funny little horns they have. What's the use?
Well, both the male and female have horns, and one of the ways you can tell the difference is that the male has no hair on the tops of the horns, the female does.
The giraffe is quite a swift mover as well when he decides to run.
It's deceiving because they are fast, but when they are at a top speed, maybe up to 50 k's an hour, because they're so tall and have such long legs and necks, they look like they're moving in slow motion, but they're actually very fast.
Well, having that head so high up, I believe they can easily spot their enemies.
They don't really have very many natural predators. A lion can, you know, a group of lions can take one down.
Mm-hmm.
And the young sometimes are taken by hyena. But it's not very common. And a lot of times when they're in a vulnerable position, when they're drinking, mm-hmm. and their legs
yeah,
are
when,
spread.
When the legs are spread and the head is down.
Yeah.
That is then dangerous. Yeah.
Then it's a dangerous time. Yeah. Or when they're young and the mother's just given birth.
So how many giraffes would there be in Tanzania?
In Tanzania,
yeah.
It's harder to tell Tanzania.
Well, at least Serengeti.
At least Serengeti. There's a lot in this park. It has a lot of suitable areas for the giraffe, and you know, probably upwards of 7,000-8,000.
Mm. Isn't it also the national animal?
Yes, it's the national animal of Tanzania.
Yeah, well worth being.
Yes.
So here we have now a group of cats again.
More cats. Three cheetahs. And we have two males and one female. The female is the one on the left. And the two males are, like we said, trying to make a fine impression on her.
Yes.
And she's being a little difficult in fending off this one, especially this one sitting down.
Now, is it typical that they are in a group like this?
Well, they're not solitary as much as, say, the, that's what she's doing, as much as the leopard.
Quite an interesting discussion.
It is. Yeah. It's not too common you find this.
Well, compared with the leopard, they are about the same size.
Yeah, they're not as heavy as the leopard. These would be about 50 kilos. Oh, look at them go after them.
Vaikka tämä gepardikolmikko onkin aggressiivisen tuntuinen, gepardit harvemmin taistelevat keskenään. Kyseessä onkin eräänlainen lemmenleikki, parittelun esirituaali, jossa kaksi urosta ottavat mittaa toisistaan, voittaakseen neitsellisen naaraan suosion. Gepardit eivät ole ihmisille varsinaisesti vaarallisia, toisin kuin leijonat.
Amazing, yeah. Well, in a litter, how many cubs would there be?
You could have up to six cubs.
Up to six?
Up to six, yeah.
Now, this is surely one of the fastest animals.
Yes, they can go up to 80 miles an hour.
That's really
70, fast. 80, the cubs.
Only for a certain time, isn't it? They can't run very long.
No, they have very small lung capacity. So their endurance is not like something like a wild dog, say, that can run for a long time. Their main prey is a Thompson's gazelle,
yeah.
And that is one of the fastest antelope, but not as fast.
And would they then be hunting daytime or?
They're diurnal hunters.
Almost always. They need the long distances and views.
Yeah.
And also if you're running at a high speed, to have the daylight. Unlike lions and leopards that hunt early morning, late afternoon. Watching a leopard now in central Serengeti, and it's a female, about 5 or 6 years old, and it's getting dark now. We're on its way to get dark, and we're waiting for it to perhaps come down. It's been up there resting.
So it hunts during the nighttime?
Yeah, it's a nocturnal. Very rarely will it hunt during the day. Its success rate is very low.
What's the favorite prey?
It prefers medium-sized antelope, impalas and lead bucks, and sometimes Thompson gazelle.
She's all alone there. Is it normal that they are solitary?
Leopard is, like most cats, solitary. Leopards will be solitary, only coming together to reproduce, and then the young will stay with the mother leopard, of course, for up to 2 years before it goes out on its own and becomes independent.
At what age can they start breeding then?
Start breeding at about the age that they're leaving their mother, between a year and the point when they leave. Average probably 1.5 years.
How many cubs could there be in a leopard litter?
You would have One to three, usually.
And a full-size leopard, how much could that be in kilos?
You'd go up to, a very big one would be up to 80, but, you know, average for a male would be 65 or so. Female's a little bit smaller.
They really enjoy sitting up high.
Well, it's
good. Not only for the view, I believe.
Well, they're not that aesthetic, really, but it's quite nice because they're staying away from their predators this way.
And they even take their prey up there when they, after a kill.
Well, it's usually, if they can, they will, because if there are lions or hyenas in the area, they'll try and steal it from the leopard. So if it keeps it up in the tree, it knows that it's safe up there.
Now, Mark, how many leopards would there be in the park?
In Serengeti, being the largest national park in Tanzania, a very large wilderness area, you would have upwards of maybe 500 or so leopards.
That's
in the
amazing.
Park. And Tanzania, as a country, has some of the, probably the, one of the highest populations of leopard as well.
Kiravaran iltanuotiolla on mukava istuskella ja kehuskella päivän bongauksilla. Kun päivän saaliiseen kuuluvat niin gepardit, leopardit, kirahvit, hipot että krokot, niin muu joukko yleensä hiljenee ja tuijottaa tuleen haaveillen huomisista hirmuista. I'm a traveling man, made a lot of stops all over the world, and in every port I own the heart of at least one lovely girl. I've a pretty señorita waiting for me,